Talk a little bit about coaching those guys up. You had some pretty impressive enthusiasm out there too, man. What did you get pumped up watching them do that?
Man, I love this game, man. I love this game, and you know, we haven't been able to play out here. I mean, just coming watching these guys competing and showing who they are and battling. You know, words can't even express my emotion right now. And just to be a part of it, man, I got to thank Nike, man, because it's just it's a great opportunity.
Sue looked like he was running his mouth early, and then things got maybe turned a little bit, and you guys seemed to have the momentum at the end. Did you feel like O-Lion won that matchup?
Yeah, I mean, yeah, Sue had a lot to say, man. We've been talking about it back and forth the whole camp, who's going to be the winners, the O-Lion and the D-Lion, and I think it's obvious today who won.
Hey, talk about what you guys are, you know, you're looking forward to this coming season. A little bit of questions at the quarterback position. Have you got any idea what you guys might do in terms of Seattle finding somebody? Do you think Charlie's the guy?
I mean, you know what? I really don't know who's going to be the guy. I'm kind of just as in the dark, but I trust Matt and I trust Charlie, and most of all, I trust the decisions being made in the front office, and they're going to put us in the best position to win. So regardless of who's back there, the offensive line is coming to work.
What kind of training have you done during the lockout? I mean, I know obviously you're on your own and it's tough, has Nike helped you with anything doing individual workouts, stuff like this?
Or? Oh yeah. I mean, I've been training throughout this whole off season, getting back to the basics, rehab and all that. And just this week, Paul Winsper, I guess he's the guy here, one of the trainers here at Nike. He's very impressive, and I've got some good work with him, as with Vasante Shianko, as well as Ndamukong Suh, and it's been great, and I'm just getting better, and by the time camp rolls around, I'll be ready.
Covering the Seahawks all last year, this is about as excited as I've ever seen you, as animated as I've ever seen you. What is it about these kids that turns that on for you, and then what pointers were you giving them, because certain guys have different technique issues, what kind of pointers were you giving them during the drills?
Just the basics, man, the same things I've been taught over the years. I'm hoping just to be able to coach them up a little bit, just kind of give them some things from my experience as well. Whether it be from your hand placement or your body positioning, I'm just giving a little bit of me.
Mm-hmm. Zach Banner, what your take on him?
Oh, Zach Banner, he's just one of the Tacoma guys.
He's
a big old kid, man. But just like the rest of these guys out here, the sky's the limit. They're only going to go up from here. And I really hope and I pray that they take this coaching and they take it home and they continuously work on it, and as well as just get better.
Did you talk to James Carpenter at all?
Yeah. Me and James have talked back and forth a little bit. Looking forward, we've got together a few times. We're looking forward to getting back with him.
What's the Russell Okung scouting report on James Carpenter, future NFL right tackle?
It's not my job to scout, but it's not my job.
But you've seen him.
Yeah, I've seen him. He's a big guy. Yeah. He's a big guy. I know he's a physical guy, great in the run game, great in the pass game as well. And I'm looking forward to not just him, but John Moffitt and the acquisition of other guys as well. That's getting back to work.
Julius Peppers was named number 10 current player overall in the recent NFL poll. Given the fact that you played against him really strong twice last year, what does that tell you about your game?
I really can't really speak on it. I had a lot of help from the offensive line guys, and Julius Peppers is a great player, and he's going to go down as one of the best one day. But I really can't say it was an individual effort. I really have to thank the rest of my offensive line just for being there to help me out with such a guy like him.
What's the main thing that you learned in your first NFL season that you can take going forward?
Just being a better student of the game, understanding how to be a better professional and how that game's going to go, and as well as holding on to those things. And, just being out here, learning that coaching's very important, and you got to grab onto what you get and hold on to it, and hopefully it manifests into something great.
In the little time you've had to talk to Coach Cable, if at all, with the lockout, what pretty intense guy, what's the vibe you get off of him?
He's an O-line guy. Yeah. And you got to respect the offensive line guy. He's going to work you. He's going to be hard-nosed. He's going to demand a lot out of you. And that's just the type of mentality you want to have as a team and even a group.
The way Hasselbeck organized that workout at the UW, kind of held everything together, it's obvious the command he has on his team. And what was your experience with him like last year?
Oh, with Matt?
Yeah.
Matt's been playing a long time. I've learned a lot from him. As we're talking about being the most, better student of the game, Matt's a veteran, and I'm hoping he comes back and have a lot more to learn. I look forward to playing with him in the future if he's there.
Yeah. Are you getting excited? You feel like it's close and you're going to finally play some football here?
I don't really know. I'm just as in the dark as you guys, but I can't wait to get back out here. And these kids are only making it harder on me.
Yeah.
So I can't wait to be back out. Yeah.